Now, as per usual, a bit of time has passed. I've been doing a little bit of decoration work, as I often do between streams. I've added a bit of trim on the paths to go around. I've replaced these paths from dirt paths to grass, from grass paths to dirt paths. It wasn't really looking right having grass here, so I've replaced them with dirt and put a nice stone trim around it, you know, around the plots. There was a group of nomads that turned up, so there has been another boost of labour. We shall see how that goes. I did put down another... I think I put down this pasture in between streams, and I put down this orchard as well. More importantly, I added a few extra houses here. You know, I let them build, so that's why time's passed a little bit more than I would have liked. I'm probably going to put some kind of production stuff along here, because for whatever reason the people are still using, you know, this open land here to get through to this marketplace. And I added this little square here. I'm probably going to extend it all the way up to the marketplace. Just make it like a long promenade type thing. My plan is to make these, you know, just curl this terrace around so that we got back-to-back housing. Surely nothing could go wrong there, right? But, as the messages say down in the bottom left, I have a low reserve of fuel, of food, rather. Once again, probably should check. Yep. That has been turned off. And I should bet it to go foraging. Just to be on the safe side. There we go. I'm also going to... I'm going to remove all the resources along here. All the stone, all the iron. All the trees. I mean, we're low on logs, so we could use the extra trees. Wow. Okay, people are cutting through the field here. Huh. Not a fan of that. Yeah, people are still doing their thing. Oh yes, that was another thing. I've got rid of the boarding house that was here. And instead, I've got this bank barn. A rather heavy-duty barns, but hopefully this will be where the people start putting the salt and the silver as a temporary measure. When I do eventually get around to expanding into this area for more industry stuff, then this bank barn will probably be used more. Ooh, got another trader coming. And seeing as I've got a lot of homeless people, it's probably a good idea to upgrade some of these houses. Because that will cause the families to rearrange themselves a bit. Ooh. And a fisherman drowned. Oh dear. That's no good. The good old trader going straight through the key. And what have you brought? Nothing that we really need. Although, let's see about getting some of that tin ore. We don't specifically need it, but having it around will keep our foundry busy. Or a foundry busy, should we need it. We'll need to get, well, 300 salt and 200 tallow. Simple. Now, speaking of foundries, there was a production facility that I saw while I was playing around off, you know, with a different settlement that I've got going. There is another, like a foundry, but for the one that doesn't require water. And I believe, yes, I believe this is the building, the forge. And, oh, well, that's yeah, we'll put it there. Seems like it's got a lot of path access, and it leaves this area open, so the barn still has access. Brilliant. Oh no. Just noticed all the cemeteries are filled with all the famines that have taken place. There's no more room in the cemeteries to bury people. Well then, I really don't know where we can build another cemetery. I mean, I guess we can just cremate people, but that apparently doesn't keep people happy. Oh well. How are we doing for food? Early autumn, so the harvests... Yeah, the harvests are coming in. So that's okay. Got textile storage here, which is pretty nice. Well, thank you very much, Winterblaze. Glad you enjoy it. Okay, so the orchard here is finally getting some work done. I mean, it hasn't been long since I've placed it, so... But actually, I'm surprised that they managed to plant all the trees within a season. The way people have been running around like headless chickens recently, and starving, kind of surprised that they had time to plant trees. Still, they've done it. Hats off to them. The cold weather's hitting early this year. It's only mid-autumn and we're already seeing snow. It's not a good sign. And go Go on. There we go. That house has finally been upgraded to as far as it can go. We still have a bunch of homeless people. So we should probably do something about that. By destroying other people's homes. I'm looking to see if there are any places here that only have one person hiding within them. Oh, the deer have made it to the lake. You may have noticed that I have flattened this section of the mountains. The rather steep slope there should be evidence enough of that. So we have access to water here, so I can start putting up docks again for more fishing. And I'm probably going to do that quite soon. But I should probably get some more houses built. Colonial Corner House, that's the one we're looking for. Build that one as well. And, why not? We'll go with three. Be daring. I should probably build a well as well. And a stonecutter was crushed by a rock. Wonderful. Oh dear. Oh, what it's like to live in a world before OSHA. Now, where are the wells? There's the well. Place a well there. I was also planning on putting a well down around here. I think that would make sense. And just to keep the people busy, I'll place down some more roads. Just widen this path a little bit. While that's going on, let's have a look at the town hall here. Okay, lots of jobs for the builders to do, but not a lot of builders to do them. Now, I have discovered that cemeteries do lose their graves after, I think it's 4 years. So they'll settle. So long as we don't fall into another death spiral in the near future, they'll fall in population again in a little while. It's not ideal, but with land being... Oh, there's another trader. Land being at kind of a premium. Oh, they're only selling clothes. I really need to plan where to put the next cemetery. Yeah, the farmers are out planting. Oh yes, I've got this raspberry field out. Speaking of which, I should probably start doing what I said I was going to do for this area and start placing down some production. Now, where is it? The Preservist. I'm going to put down another Preservist here to let us make some jam, hopefully. Now, the builders are still being quite slow. Ah, that's why. We've got a shortage on stone. I didn't realise. Hey, Hogan. Nice to see you. And thank you very much. I'm glad I can supply you with a level of comfiness. Especially on days like this. Hope your day's been going well. People are now starting to use a route this way. Reserve of food is low. Oh dear. We're still having to forage. Yeah, my day's been a little bit hectic, but totally manageable. Actually, I'm kind of thankful that it's been a little more busy than usual. Oh yes, this pasture. Don't have anyone in it yet, and don't have a worker for it. And I was going to put some beef cows in there. So we'll split this herd. Now it does mean that we won't be able to make use of the cows here for making meat because we need to replenish the stock. But after that, we'll be getting double the amount of beef. Think about what I want to do regarding this situation. Do I want to flatten? I was thinking about keeping this mountain just as a reminder that there was a big hill here. But, I mean, if the people are using this as a way to get to the new town, then I should probably terraform it. Yeah, the reserve of stone is low. Yeah, we know that. Okay, I think we probably should... bring the bring the mountain down a little bit along here. We'll try to preserve as much of it as we can, but I mean the traffic here is just, yeah, look at it. Means I'm going to have to do quite a bit of transforming around here. Hmm. Yeah, just trying to envision what the path, the pathing would be like. I mean, we might be able to squeeze a butcher's in here. Once again, having problems with food. So if I can get a butcher's in there, might be able to slip a road in down this way. So I want to leave this open, this area open for like, coastline type industry. Let's check this out, see what... Actually, before I do that, it's probably worthwhile me checking the production stocks. Even better, check the inventory, see what... So we've got no beef. That's understandable. We've just cut our beef supply temporarily. What about mutton? Mutton, we got a little bit, but not a whole lot. Venison, same deal. Nothing in the trading post. I think I was saying previously that I would want to try and get some pigs so we can have sausages. If I wasn't saying that in the previous session, I was thinking it while I was doing the in-between session decoration work. Okay, I think it's, I think that's telling me that I need to, once again, picking the incorrect, we'll make pickled eggs from here for now. Still not able to get a fruit that... we can turn into jam. You want Jesus in this town? Well, we got Jesus in this town. Jesus lives here. Ah, there we go. The terrace is being expanded, and it looks like we got rid of the homeless problem. Okay. Once again, reserve of stone is low. And we got a lot of labourers, so I think I'll increase the population of the quarry. Double it. And there's another trader. I don't know which Jesus it is, to be honest, Sorrow. Could be Korean. But no, this is probably more Buddy Jesus. Tin. Only 10 sheets of tin. No, that's not really what we need. Ah, but this is up and running now. And it's taking iron ore. How much iron ore do we have? I thought we were just producing iron from here. Yeah, we are. It must be iron ore that we've picked up from our scavenging. Let's have a look. Iron ore. Yeah, 73 is not a whole lot, so... fair enough. We'll let them go through that, and then we'll switch over to tin. The tin ore. Let them smelt that. Of course, the herd of cows are going to take a while to replenish. What are we doing? Okay, should probably extend the roads again. All the way along here. Ooh, and another stonecutter has a rock fall on them. Oh, yes. Yeah. Probably best to do a bit more foraging everywhere we can. You'll need to do something about this. I'll get rid of that, and... place that along there. I think that's just enough room to squeeze a butcher's in there. Trying to be careful with extending this path. pulling up a little bit of the ground from, you know, and reclaiming some of the lake, but trying not to go too crazy with it. Okay, there we go. That's that. Okay, and finish it off with this stone path. There we go. Connect it up. And they'll start using that path soon, hopefully.